Hey everyone, in today's video, we will show you how to use the HouseIt debt to income ratio calculator. Now the calculator helps you figure out both your front end and back end debt to income ratio. And those ratios are very important when you think about home affordability for your mortgage, for example, or if you're buying a co-op in New York City, how much you can afford and comply with any co-op requirements on debt to income ratio. So if you're not already on the calculator, there's two ways to get here. The first way is to visit our website, houseit.com. Spelling is up here. Go to resources, scroll down to calculators, and the debt to income ratio calculator is right there. The other option is to type in directly into your search bar or your address bar, houseit.com/debt-to-income-ratio-calculator. The spelling is up above. So the calculator allows us to figure out two different things. One is the front end debt to income ratio, and the other is the back end debt to income ratio. So perhaps we can go over that very quickly. If you scroll down to our glossary and FAQ section, we have the definitions right here. So the front end debt to income ratio is the percentage of pre-tax gross monthly income, which covers housing expenses. Now this includes your mortgage payment, property taxes. If you own a condo, it would include your common charges. If you own a co-op, it would be your monthly maintenance payment to the building. This would also include homeowner's insurance. Now, the front-end debt-to-income ratio only includes housing-related expenses. So if you owned a Porsche or if you had a Toyota Camry, whatever it might be, and you had a lease payment for that, the front-end debt-to-income ratio does not factor in that monthly liability that you have to pay for your car, or for student loans, or if you have and maintain credit card balances. Now, the back end debt to income ratio is everything the front end ratio is, but we also add in those other liabilities that we just mentioned, student loan payments, car payments, anything that you have to constantly pay every month, that will also appear on your credit report. So if we go up to the calculator, here you can actually input all of the required items to figure out your front and back end DTI. The most important item is your income. And keep in mind, as we've mentioned, this is your total pre-tax income. It should include everything that would be on a tax return: wages, dividend income, rental income, and stipends. Now, two ways to do it. If you prefer to think about your income as an annual figure, you can put that in directly. Or if you think more about things on a monthly basis, you can toggle between annual and monthly as far as your income is concerned. Now here in housing expenses, you have that same option. You can think about everything in an annual basis or on a monthly basis. And the things we need to know would be your mortgage payment, your common charges in case of a condo. We'd need to know your property taxes if you own a condo or a house. Keep in mind a co-op, there would not be anything in this field. And if you own a co-op, you would fill in the maintenance fees. And remember that a co-op pays property taxes directly on behalf of unit owners. So if you own a condo, you have two things to pay every month. You have to pay your common charges and you have to pay property taxes. With a co-op, you just pay your co-op maintenance. Of course, in either case, you would also pay your mortgage if you are financing. The other things that are included in front-end DTI are your homeowner's insurance payment, as well as any private mortgage insurance that you may have. Other expenses would include, but are not limited to, student loan payments, credit card payments, car lease or other loan payments, as well as any other mandatory payments you're on the hook for. For the purposes of this example, let's go ahead and put in $500 for a car loan payment. Now, as we can see on the top right, we have two calculations. We have the front end DTI and the back end DTI. The back end debt to income ratio is always going to be slightly higher, assuming that you have other non-housing related liabilities that you have to pay on a monthly basis. So if, for example, you decide to get rid of the car, you don't want it anymore, and you pay off your credit card, we put zero for both of these fields, and you'll see that the front and back end DTI are now the same. But the back end can never be lower than the front end. So if we add credit card payments, let's say you pay $700 a month, you got a hefty balance, your back end ratio is going to start to creep up and be higher than the front end. Most mortgage lenders will underwrite up to approximately 43% as far as a debt to income ratio is concerned. Co-ops typically are looking for 25 to 30%. In some cases, low 30% will be okay. Really depends on the building, and you're gonna wanna have your buyer's agent check in with management and the listing agent to try to get a read on what sort of requirements, financially speaking, the co-op may have. Some co-ops don't actually disclose what the requirements are, and other co-ops are very explicit in terms of what they require, as and in some cases, also how to calculate things such as post-closing liquidity, what sort of assets would count for that. But we have a whole bunch of videos on the HAUSIT YouTube channel, which talk about everything you need to know for buying a co-op, including financial requirements, as well as the board package. So please check us out if you haven't already, or visit our website, hausit.com. So the calculator is pretty straightforward. We hope you find it helpful. You can also do two things with it. You can send yourself an email, which will be great because you can forward it to family or friends or anyone you're deliberating with, maybe even to your lender as necessary. And you can also print out a PDF. So this would be great if you want to save it down, email it to anyone, or just have it on file for your records. Thanks again for watching. I'm Nick at HAUSIT. If you have any questions, please leave us a comment below. If you like the video, hit like, subscribe to our channel. We greatly appreciate it. You can also send us an email to team@hausit.com. And of course, if you would like to save money when selling or buying here in the city, check out our website, hausit.com. Number of ways you can save money. So that's all for today's video. Thanks again for watching. We hope to see you on the next one.